Sick of all these people talking, sick of all this noise. Tired of all these cameras flashing, sick of being poised. Now my neck is open wide, begging for a fist around it. Already choking on my pride, so there's no use crying about it.
Mirror, mirror on the wall, who is the fairest of them all?
Natasha and is Kelsey Israel's Brandy Candy Vega Helen Valiant Ella Walker Ryan Warzone Shammer Fagin, Sin of Iraq, Brad Big Time Drama Games Rage Chen Silk
Welcome everybody to the Royal Kingdom Tournament. It's time for our first match. It's time for the first match of the Queen's Royal Kingdom Tournament. Coming out first is your JOW Women's Champion, Natasha Hammy. You can see the thrones. And you can see the pyro.
The following contest is a championship first round match. Making her way to the ring from New York, the women's champion, Soul Man, Natoli.
You see that woman's championship around the waist of Natasha. Natasha has done everything there is to do in a matter of months here in JOW. She has accomplished so many things faster than anyone else has ever done in history. Can she add becoming queen of JOW to that list? It won't be easy. She has to go 1-1. With Kelsey Israel, but she could do it just like she has done, defeat the odds every single other time she won either one of these championships, one of those battle royals, one of these ladder matches. She has done it every single time. How is everyone doing tonight?
is Thursday. It is JOW night. It is a Royal Kingdom Tournament 2022. And it is Kelsey Adriel's opportunity to become a queen. She is from wherever she wants. She is the woman who has just defeated Natasha 1 week ago. Bazon, the only time these two have fought one-on-one, because last year's Royal Kingdom Tournament, they kicked this thing off last year as well. Last year, Natasha coming out on top. Last week, Kelsey coming out on top. They are 1-1 in the season. In the month of June, 2 years, a lot of history, a lot of building up, and it's all built up to right here tonight. Who can get the win? Who can get the victory? Who can make it into the next round of this year's Royal Kingdom Tournament and possibly become Queen of JOW? Of course, both these women were both included in that. Both of them were just recently had title opportunities for the Women's Championship. Kelsey didn't quite get it. Griffin was able to become Women's Champion. Natasha cashed in her contract immediately after that match, which ended up giving us that one-on-one match between the two last week. But tonight there is no Brian Azrael in the corner of Kelsey. That may completely change everything in this match. This is strictly one-on-one, no distractions. Oh, but look at that. I don't know if Natasha quite got off the way she wanted to. Maybe got a little bit of a bad launch. Didn't quite get what she was looking for. But she's definitely got the strength advantage in this one. The size advantage as well. And she just powered up and powered down Kelsey Azrael. And now look at this. The submission locked in. The walls of Natasha, but not quite enough yet. Too early on. Kelsey locking in the face. And a big kick to the midsection of Natasha. Kelsey going to the top rope and does the same thing Natasha attempted, but this time lands it. What a stacked tournament on both the Kings and the Queens side we have here tonight. This is only the beginning. But whoever wins this one has, in my mind, has a very good chance of winning this whole thing. Two of JOW's women's division's best. But there's so much more, so many more people in the match, including three jesters here tonight. Who will be taking those spots? We've seen what winning this tournament has done for the careers of both Ninja and Lisa. It can very well do just as much of just as much for the whoever wins this year. Right now, Natasha's trying to go back to the top rope. She messed up the first time. Can she get this time? No. Changing her mind. Deciding to keep a more grounded base. And I think that's a great strategy for Natasha. We've seen Kelsey flying around earlier. One, two, no. We see Kelsey flying around earlier and it was working out for her. But I think Natasha's gonna have it. Oh, but look at that! Just spitting poison mist into the face of Natasha. I don't know how legal that is, but the ref is not counting her out. But look at this, looking to set up the black mass. It's all over. Mist and mass. One, two, three, no!
Natasha kicking out Stang in this fight. Catching the hand, slapping the side of the head as Kelsey tries to fight her way back into this. Tries to fight her back into her way back into the top of this match, into control. Now, Natasha face first into that turnbuckle. And a suplex. But too close to the ropes.
I think Kelsey's pretty much got this one won. She just needs to hit one last big move, and that might be what she's doing right here. Frog splash, the knees were up by Natasha, and now getting pounded and stomped into the canvas, into the mat. Takes down Kelsey, picks her up, tosses her over. But this time, looking to finally successfully go to the top with that leg drop. One, two, three. No! Kelsey just kicks out at two. What will it take? What will it take to advance this first match of the night? The very same match that kicked off last year's tournament, but this year, both these women are very, very different, very, very, well, improved from the last year. But Tombstone Piehole Driver. That's it. One, two, three. No! Natasha kicks out. Natasha will not die tonight. But I think it's all about over. If the black mass connects. One, two, three. What a fight from our women's champion, but 2 weeks in a row, Kelsey Azrael pins clean Natasha in the middle of the ring. It was all, I think that's where the momentum really shifted. The poison missed. Natasha almost got back into the match with that leg drop, but wasn't quite enough to put away the win. That Tombstone Pile Driver. And then in the end, the Black Mass put this one away for Kelsey Azrael. For the favor of Kelsey Azrael. And she advances to round two. Natasha, she's knocked out. If you lose one match here tonight, you are out for the remainder of the tournament. Unfortunately for Natasha, but very fortunately, if you're Kelsey Azrael, you are moving on to the next round. As you can see here, Azrael moves on. That Azrael moves on. We'll find out who she fights later on. But next, it's the first match of the men's tournament. It is one half of the tag team champions.
The following contest is a King of the Ring first round match, making his way to the ring from Marieville, Quebec, Canada. Weighing in at 260 pounds, one half of the Tag Team Champions, Ryan Warlord.
Ryan Warzone holding that championship tight. The bird mask is intact. But can he become king? Can he become King Warzone here tonight? What an opportunity it is. Not only can you become Tag Team Champion, but you can also become king I mean, the tag titles was his first title here in JRW. Why not become king as well? Why not stack everything on the year, on the 2020 career of Ryan Warzone? Make this Ryan Warzone's best year in the career of this veteran. But he's going against another veteran, another OG of JRW. He's going against the Dragon, Son of Wrath, Brad.
And his opponent from London, England, weighing in at 255 pounds, the Dragon, Brad.
Can he become not only the Dragon King, Son of Wrath, can he become the Dragon King? Can he become King Brad here tonight? Defeat Ryan Warzone, move to whoever's next. Make it all the way to the main event and become your brand new king. It would be a huge victory for Brad. Get him straight back to the world title picture. The main event scene after that loss against Architect. But it's not gonna be easy. Ryan Warzone has been doing better than ever. He's been at the top of his game as of late. One half of the tag team champions. But so has Brad. Both these guys have never been better. Oh, but look, knees up from Ryan Warzone. Brad was looking to end things early. Ryan Warzone with the knees up. But now driving him head first, Brain Buster, Moonsault, going for the early finish. 1, 2, 3, but not quite. Just kicking out is Ryan Warzone. I mean, good strategy from Brad. This is a tournament. You have to win this one as soon and easily as possible. Oh, but look, draping down, but Brad came back to his feet. He knows he can't take much damage, but that dropkick sends him down. Ryan Warzone's never been afraid of taking damage, never been afraid of getting into a fight, but tonight is the one exception of that. He's gotta keep himself at 100% or as close to it throughout the night if he wants to become king later on. But two repeated pile drivers into the pin, but kick out, not even a one count. That's what the strength, that's the fight in Ryan Warzone I was just speaking of. Big knee strike for, whoa. Poison Rana. And now setting up Ryan Warzone. Looking for that finishing move, but no. Ryan Warzone tosses him over top. Falcon's Arrow. One of Ryan Warzone's best moves, and that's it. That's all. 1, 2, 3, no! Brad kicks out at 2. Caught the forearm. Tosses Warzone into the corner. But a big forearm to get out of the corner from Warzone. Then to the back, Brad landing on the top of the head, and now a moonsault from Ryan Warzone. 1, 2, no, only a 2 count. Elbow drop into the spine there from Ryan Warzone. He's got to stay on the fight. You can't let Brad get back into this. And a coup de grace, double stomps into the, oh, was looking for the spear, looking for the finish. But Brad sauce in the head. And now that power bomb, it's over. 1, 2, 3. Brad advances to the semi-final round. What a match it was. It could have went either way. These two had a very good strategy of just trying to come in and get an early victory. Seems the one with the better strategy was Brad, coming out on top, defeating one half of the tag team champions. He will go one-on-one with one of the Steel Brothers. We'll have to wait and see which one that is. And that is the bracket. Brad advances. He will face either Chance or Chandler. Here is your next competitor. Helen Valiant returning to the JOW main roster here tonight at JOW's Royal Kingdom Tournament 2022. One half of Valiant Flame on JOW Exhibition. Just recently returning there as well with a loss at GameShifter to the debuting Misaki Tanaka and Shawnee Gears. She was teaming with the number 2 ranked Veronica Flame. Tonight it's Helen's singles opportunity tonight. Can she, much like her teammate, climb to the top of the rankings of the Exhibition Women's Division? She is currently 0-0 this year. But this tournament can really turn around your singles record. It can possibly give you a 3-0 record in one night. It won't be easy. Won't be easy for anyone in this tournament. But she goes 1-1 with the Exhibition Women's Champion, Bella Lockjaw. Tonight's a very special night. We've got competitors from not only here on the JOW main roster, but we've also got the Exhibition. Many people from the Exhibition roster coming to the Royal Kingdom Tournament, trying to become royalty, trying to become king and or queen. And Bella Lockjaw, we know her well here on the main roster before going down to Exhibition. But since going to Exhibition, she has become Exhibition Women's Champion. Grabbing that first championship in her JOW career. This is the best Bella Lockjaw we have ever seen. Can she get a victory over Helen Valiant to move on? That's what we're here to find out. What we're here to see. Who can become queen? Who can make it? Who can defeat the odds? So far, early on in this one, it seems to be Bella Lockjaw, the women's champion, taking control. One, but not even one count there. Helen with a kick and a chop and a chop. And now a suplex. takes down the champ. Helen climbs to the top rope. What's she looking to set Bella into? Changes her mind. But Bella caught her. And now a suplex of her own. What would it mean if Bella Lockjaw could become Queen Lockjaw as well as Exhibition Women's Champion? She would be the most dominant and most powerful woman on Exhibition if she were to do so. Queen Lisa Vegas had a great run. She decided not to run this year, not to try to become queen again. She wanted to see that crown land onto the next rightful woman's head. That crown brought her so many things. Brought her the women's championship. Brought her so many victories in Lisa Vega's career here in JW. Made her a main event player. It could do the same for someone like Helen Valiant. What if she were to win one half of the tag team known as Valiant Flame? But what a singles accomplishment it would be for Helen. And right now Helen pulling a Bella Lockjaw. That O'Reilly. Now on the top rope. But getting caught, getting tossed down onto the mat. And now a knee strike into the face. And now watch up to the top with a drop kick, sending Helen Valiant down. One, only a one count. But Bella Lockjaw does not want to give up. She's going to keep on this fight. But neither is Helen Valiant. Valiant coming from behind, snapping down Bella Lockjaw, climbing her way to the top rope, just stalking her, measuring that knee into the face of Bella. One, only a one count. Bella Lockjaw is not giving up, but neither is Valiant. I'll do it one more time. But no, this time open for Bella to get to her feet. And didn't actually super kick. She said, I'll make you think that I'm going for that knee, but I'm going to hit you with this super kick on the money. And now he's looking for some sort of a submission hold. Lockjaw slips behind Saihido. And now fists, close fists into the face of Helen Valiant. Can Bella make her tap middle of the ring? No rope breaks available for Helen Valiant. She may tap right here, but no. Let's go. Of that hold. And now into the pin. One, two, no. Helen still has fight left in her. Thought she might have been knocked out. But not yet. Not quite enough to knock out the lights. Take out Helen Valiant. We're seeing a great fight from here against the Exhibition Women's Champion. Of course, Bella Lockjaw will defend her championship against Helen's partner, Veronica Flame, at Exhibition's 1 year anniversary coming up in a few weeks. But right now, one. No, not even a one count. Bella Lockjaw has still got fight left in her. That is why she's the women's champion. That is why she's made it into this tournament in the first place. And a forearm smash to the face of Lockjaw. Pulling and tugging onto the arm, trying to pull it clean off of the shoulders. Kick into the mix session.
takes down, takes out the legs, and now a running knee, but dodged, averted, and a big kick, and a thrust kick as well. One, two, three. No, I thought that was it. I thought Helen had the biggest singles victory of her career. And she might still have it if she can hit the finishing touch right here. The finishing move with that lumbar check into the pin. Ref in position. One, two, three. No! So close, but so far away. She's not giving up. The fight of Helen Valiant, the biggest fight we've seen in her career. She's got this submission hold locked in, and she makes the champ tap. Unbelievable victory for Helen Valiant, making that submission specialist one of the best submission technicians we have to offer, making her tap clean in the middle of the ring. And Helen Valiant will move on to the semi-final round,
your winner, Helen!
Where Helen Valiant will go one-on-one with Kelsey Azrael, possibly the biggest victory in Helen Valiant's career, the biggest opportunity if she can keep this party rolling. Don't pay attention to the graphic. Our graphic makers are idiots. It is Kelsey Azrael taking on Helen Valiant in the next round. But it's time to find out who the better brother is. Cell Team 6 collides right here tonight. Only one of them can leave King. One of them eliminated first round. Champion versus champion. Which Cell brother will stand tall?
The following contest is a King of the Ring first round match. Making his way to the ring from Oak Park, Illinois. Weighing in at 244 pounds. The wrestling champion. The Assassin, Charlie Simpson.
Our announcer just stubbed it a little bit. Well, that's fine. That's great. That's dandy. Chancel, your five-star wrestling champion, trying to become king. Trying to defeat his brother first round. This is the first time, as far as I'm aware, off the top of my head, that the Cell brothers will collide one-on-one in JOW history. But he is glorious. Chancel has not only this to look out for, but also Cody Storm, his next title defense as well. Cody Storm should be watching this one. He should be scouting out Chancel before the biggest opportunity of his JOW career in 2 weeks. Or next, yeah, 2 weeks.
New York, weighing in at 254 pounds. One half of the Tag Team Champions, Unbreakable Chandler.
He is no longer the future. The future has arrived. He is a present. He's unbreakable. And he is one half of your JOW Tag Team Champions. But this fight is going to be personal. This fight is between two brothers. A tag team. A tag team since birth. They've known each other their entire lives. And their entire lives, they have fought both together and separately. Until this point.
both have been able on their own to become champions this year. This year, both will tell you that this year has been the year of the Sills. Chandler grabbing championships around the community, becoming JOW Tag Team Champion. Chance Sill becoming 5-star wrestling champion at Born for Glory, defeating the longest reigning champion ever in Luke. Both these guys have so much momentum on their sides, but only one of them can make it to the semifinal rounds. Only one of them can go one-on-one with Brad. Which one will that be? Tag champ versus 5-star wrestling champ. Chandler Sill is here for respect, as he said in that promo, to get himself into this tournament. It was tied with Chandler, or it was tied with Chance as the top rated men's promo we had. It was rated by myself and our two former royalty, our former Queen and King, King Ninja and Queen Lisa. All of us loved both of those promos from the Sill Brothers. And now, Chance looking for a victory right here. 1, 2, no, not even a 2 count against his brother. Chandler coming into this one with a new attire, debut on this attire in JOW. First time we're seeing it in the JOW ring. And now, cross body. He's got that new tattoo as well. He is the Batman. Chandler said he will rule all of JOW. If he's gonna do it, it's gonna be personal, it's gonna be tough. He's got to go through his brother. But his brother may go through him, but not quite yet, anyways. Chandler still not giving up yet. Who do you guys got winning this? Which Sill brother will outdo the other? Do you guys got the 5-star wrestling chance? Do you got the tag team champion, Chandler? I say it's a pretty even fight. Both have been doing so good, so great this year. It's a pretty even contest. It's hard to pick a winner. But tell me in the chat who you got. Right now, it might be Chandler getting the victory over his brother, but only a 2 count. He's gonna be thinking, what will it take to put him away? But he might have found the answer. This is how he's won so many matches with a clay. More. 1, 2, 3, no. I thought that was it. I thought he defeated Chance Sill with the claymore. But you can't count out the brother yet. He knows what to expect from Chandler. A diving elbow drop. And look at that. 1, 2, no. Chance still in this. Chance in his promo said that he's already a 5-star wrestling champion. He is already one of the best in JOW. But there is this tournament. This is opportunity to become king of JOW. He's number one ranked.
So why not make it official? Why not make him the best in JW? Why not become king of this whole thing? And he may do it, but he's got to go through his brother. I've said that so many times. But this is personal. This is family. It doesn't get any bigger than this. But locking in the submission is Chandler Sill. There's nowhere for Chess to go. Nowhere for him to go except for to tap. Will he do it? No. Chandler letting go of his brother. Chandler once again looking to set up that Claymore. If he hits it, it's all done. It's all over. Claymore connects. That's gotta be it. There's no way he kicks out. 1, 2, 3. Chandler Sill advances to face the semi-final challenge. The challenge to become king is so close. That match, for the most part, I believe was pretty well one-sided for Chandler Sill. Maybe surprising to some people. Chandler standing tall over his brother with a massive victory for one half of the tag team champions. It'll be Brad and Chandler in the semi-finals. But up next, that means that we have our first Jester match of the night. Who will the Jester be? He will go one-on-one with Brandi Ryder, the motorbike rider. Brandi. As she parks her bicycle, her motorbike in front of the crowd, in front of the Royal Kingdom Tournament. She's here to attempt to become queen. The biggest opportunity of her career so far, if she can win, become queen of JOW. What a victory it would be for Brandi Ryder. It's not going to be easy. The odds are stacked against Ryder tonight. She has no clue who her opponent will be. And we're about to find out together who is the first Jester of three. It's the debuting Jesse Bandana. What a massive opportunity for Jesse here tonight in her JOWW in the Royal Kingdom Tournament.
And from San Jose, California, Jesse.
If you don't know who Jesse is, you're about to find out. She is the card community's superhero. She's a high-flying and technical master. And she has arrived here in JOW to rise to the top, become queen of JOW in her very first night on the job. But do you guys think that Jesse can get it done? Can't she defeat someone with the skill set, the arsenal of Brandi Ryder? Brandi's been on the main roster before. She knows the big fight feel. She's been on exhibition as of late, but now, for one night only, back here, back on pay-per-view, to take on Jessie. I'd say Brandi Rhyder has the size advantage, maybe the strength advantage as well in this one. I've never called a match of Jessie's before, but from what I've seen, she's a great high flyer. She's a great technician. She's a great all-around talent. As she climbs to the top rope, let's see what she can do. Let's see how high she can fly. And look at that. Takes down Brandi Rhyder. She's got all the tricks and tools needed to take down Rhyder. If she can put it all together, she may get this one done in her debut match. But look at the strikes, one after another, until getting caught. Insegurity blocked there from Brandi Rhyder. Brandi grabs the arm, smashes the head into the floor, into the canvas. And now backfist, strike, but Jessie will not be taken off her feet. She's still standing after all those strikes. That has to be something in the fight, in the strength of Jessie Bandana. One, two, three. What a quick victory. That's how it's done if you're Brandi Rhyder. I mean, all the strength, I think Jessie, she tried to stay on her feet the best she could, but I think she was out cold after that one. But that's what you have to do. This is a World King tournament. You have to stay as fresh as possible. And that's exactly what Brandi Rhyder does. She stays fresh, and she moves on to the semifinals, defeating the Jester. She glows as she exits the first round, but up next is Drama take on Trelly, who will also advance to the semifinals from Exhibition. Our first inaugural Exhibition champion. He just lost that gold, that silver championship last week at Game Shifter in the main event against Sam Danger. He has since changed his attitude. It's no longer about titles, it's about winning matches. First round match, making his way to the ring from Houston, Texas, weighing in at 257 pounds, Duke Drama. Duke Drama, like I said, recently losing that Exhibition Men's Championship to Sam Danger. But that is not shaking the former champ. He is looking to now just pile up on the victories, get himself to the top of the rankings, prove he is the best. He's going to start from the bottom, make his way to the top. That loss at Game Shifter derailed all that momentum that is layered on the shoulders of Drama since his debut. But that's not going to end the career that some people that were just sent down in a spiraling shift of power. But he wants to become a king tonight. He wants to kick everyone's ass and get the respect that comes with it. He wants to become king. But to do so, he has to beat the big time Trelly. From Chicago,
Chicago, Illinois, weighing in at 379 pounds, Big Time T.
Making his, both these guys are making their JOW Bane roster debuts here at the Royal Kingdom Tournament. It's a very special event in that we will see not only people from the main roster, but also this was open to people on the exhibition roster. We get the best of both worlds, best of both brands. And someone who's the best of all brands is the Big Time. He's making this tournament in the Big Time. And he's looking to become Big Time King. Trelly, if he can make it into the semifinals, make it against Duke Darama, won't be easy going against the first ever exhibition champ, but it certainly is not impossible. And look at this, didn't quite get it, but that is what you can expect from Trelly. If you're not familiar with him, if you're not familiar with this bandage flying, Big Timing Trelly, that is exactly what you can expect here as he goes one-on-one with Duke Darama. Very agile for a man his size. Some would say impossible agility from Trelly. Duke Darama doesn't care. Duke Darama doesn't care how many flips Trelly can do, because Drama's just going to try to get a victory here tonight. He's just here to kick Trelly's ass. He's just here to knock him out of this tournament. He wants to move on to the next round where he can defeat whoever else makes it into the pin, but not enough. Got the submission locked in on Duke Darama. Duke Darama able to get out of it. Big chop and a big strike as well. And a big clothesline to the back of the head. Knee strike takes down T. Twisting the arm, grabbing the other, snapping it right off the shoulder. Clean off the bone. Drummer just ripping at the eyes, ripping at the face, ripping at the nose maybe of Trelly. This is the first time we're seeing this match in a JOW ring. They both share a locker room down on exhibition. This is a huge opportunity for both men in their JOW main roster debut. Can they become king? One, two, no, only a two count. Trelly kicks out. Look at this, the rock bottom from Duke Darama as he sets Trelly up for yet another Darama bottom. One, two, three. Duke Darama has made it into the semifinals. We see Trelly coming straight out the gates. Spanish flies, flipping his way off the top. But in the end, it was Duke Darama who's playing the long game. It was Duke Darama who came out on top. Two Darama bottoms were able to keep down Big Trelly, giving Darama the victory.
Here is your winner, Duke!
He said he wants to kick everyone's ass since losing that championship. And that's a great way to start doing so. He's got Dragonheart in his feature on exhibition. But he's also got a tough challenge later on tonight against whoever qualifies to make it into the semi-finals with him. But up next, we'll find out who will face Brandi Rider. Will it be the returning Candy Vega? Or will it be the Jesser number 2? This is going to be the first time we see Candy Vega in action ever since the first Born for Glory.
The following contest is a championship first round match, making her way to the ring from Columbia, South Carolina, Big Eva, CKV.
14 months. It's been 14 months since Candy Vega has stepped into the JOW ring, coming up short in the Women's Championship match against Millie Hughes. Candy Vega, one of the best the JOW Women's Division has ever seen since Born for Glory 1. She has gone on to join management, currently one of the general managers over on exhibition. She's kind of left the gear at home, worn the suit to work, and making business decisions for the rest of the roster. But tonight, she's decided, let's step out of retirement. Let's take my spot as queen of JOW. Lisa did last year. Let's keep it in the Vega bloodline. Let's keep this in the royal family. But she does not know who she's going one-on-one against. We're about to find out together who will be the Jesser. It is Jada Merchantson making her JOW debut. A tag team partner of Jesse Bandana, who you've seen as a first Jesser here tonight. And she's here to fight one of the best, one of the greatest in the women's division in JOW as a whole. She's here to defeat the green-haired? I don't know. But she's here to defeat Candy Vega and get her spot. Get the spot that her tag team partner was unable to receive, unable to attain at the top of the queendom. Oh, but toss rein to the referee. That'll slow down Candy Vega as she goes face first into the mat. I'm very intrigued to see what Jada can do here in this debut match against Candy Vega. Candy sets it up. Jada Saito suplex. This is a final spot into the semifinals. Who do you guys got winning it? Can Candy Vega come back into the JOW ring for the first time in 14 months, get a huge victory, make it into the semifinals of the Royal Kingdom Tournament? Or will Jada make her debut and win her debut match against one of the best of all time? Tell me in the chat who you guys got winning this. Going into the pin, but not even enough for a one. That is a veteran, Candy Vega, Big jab, big punch, comes behind, plants down Kenny Vega. Candy grabbing her, plants down Jada. Ripping at that arm. Alright, Candy Vega said she wants to come in this tournament. She wants to fight the best of the best. And winning that crown would be icing on the cake. Well, Jada may very well become the best of the best if she can defeat Candy Vega in her debut match. And look at that, ass to the face. She hit her with a Naomi, the rear view. And looking to set up the super kick, right on the money, right on the Vega, right on the Candy, rope, break. That is why she's one of the best. The ring awareness. She may have been down and out, but Candy Vega grabbing that bottom rope, breaking things up. And with the kick to the midsection. And now we see this earlier from Helen with the O'Reilly combination. One, no. Jada out at one. And no, Jada getting herself back. Kick to the midsection. Looking to plant her down. One, two, three. No! And that was it. That would debut victory. That would have been for Jada. But she has to keep on the fight. She almost had this thing won. Moonsault. But Candy back to her feet. Big knee strike into the midsection. For the first time since Born for Glory, the curb stomp from Vega. That has put away so many people, and now the cutter as well. One, two, three, no! How did Jada kick out? How is she still in it? But the triangle hold locked in. That's a triangle, I guess, right? Sure it is. And it's gonna make her tap, but no. Maybe powering up Candy Vega. As she hits her with these strikes, plants her into the knee, and sets up one more super kick. Right on the money. But again, the ropes. Too close to the ropes both times. And now on the shoulders, ring around the Rosie's pockets full of slammies. Ashes, ashes, we all fall down, says Jada. But not for long, because now back in control is Candy Vega. That suplex toss on Jada over top. And now, big forearm strike to the back of the head of Jada into the pin. One, two, no, only a two count. Not enough to make it to the next round in her returning match. What will be enough? What will be the final beat into the head, into Jada. There's gotta be something that finishes this one off, but we haven't seen it yet. Oh, sent over top, almost straight to the floor. But no, Candy Vega ducks. Jada sent right there, and now into the knee. Knee into the spine as well. Takes down the legs. And setting up maybe the cutter. The Vega cutter. But no, too close to the ropes. That's a mistake I was not expecting to see from Candy Vega. But missed with the first, connects with the second. Into the pin. Two. No, out at two is Jada. What will it take for Candy Vega to become queen? What will it take for Candy Vega to get the first victory in over 14 months? It might take this. The curb stomp connects. But doesn't go for the pin. That's a mistake. That is a huge mistake from Candy Vega. And look at that innovative offense. German suplex. What a suplex that was. Now just staring down the face. Both going for something, but neither able to hit it. Now into the corner goes Candy Vega. And grabbing the arm is Jada. Twisting and popping. One, two, three. Oh, that was it. That almost had it won for Jada in her debut. She almost defeated the best. And the super kick one more time. And now climbing to the top rope. Looking to finish off Candy Vega once and for all. Dropkick, but missed. Candy moves out of the way. Last second. Big roundhouse kick. Sending Jada into the corner. Sending her up, but Jada dodges. Kick to the face. Jada, kick to the midsection now. Plants Candy Vega center, but doesn't go for the pin. Candy grabs the leg. And the cutter. The Vega cutter one last time. One, two, three. She does it. What a match. What a debut. What a return. What a tournament match. It could have went either way in the end. You've seen so much from both sides. And in the end, it worked out for Candy Vega.
Big Evil CKV.
Candy Vega competes in her first match in 14 months, comes out on top. That is why she's the best to ever do it. Or at least very, very near the top of the list. As the general manager of exhibition joins Brandi Rhyder in the semifinals. We've got the Queen's side all sorted out for the semifinals, but we're about to find out. Will be James Rage, will be a jester, the final jester of the night. To come on Duke Drama.
The following contest is a King of the Ring first round match. Making his way to the ring from Warsaw, Poland. Weighing in at 275 pounds. The Dragon Guy, James Rage. Go down.
the dragon guy can become the dragon king. Can King Rage get that crown? Get himself the biggest, possibly the biggest victory of his career. If he can make it right to the finals, if he can make it to the crown, to the throne. But this is a Jester, the third and final Jester of the night. And what a Jester it is. Welcome to JOW, Jason Evans. Jason Evans here in the Men's Royal Kingdom Tournament, looking to become king of JOW in his debut match. He's won titles around different places, and he is here to join JOW. He's here to make some facts. He's here to put away James Rage, the dragon guy, and become king of JOW. And that's not unpredictable. That's damn fact. Bell is rung, here we go. And Evans straight out of the gates. I mean, James Rage did not know who he's going to one-on-one against before right now, before we all together found out. And Jason Evans biting the fingers. And look at this. Moonsault, but dodged. James Rage moving out of the way, but the crossbody. And Jason Evans moves out of the way. Evans into the pin. Out at two is James Rage. Jason Evans, a huge name to be added to the JOW roster. And look at that, into the knees as one of James Rage's best moves. Rage from behind, planting down Evans. Got the arms locked in, into the knees. And was looking for a lariat, but dodged. And look at this, the showboating from Evans. It says, ah, you fall on your face. But it may have been dancing a little too long, because now, oh no, but it slips behind, takes up the knee, takes up the legs. James Rage on his rail right now, getting stomped right in those scars, right in the sewed up back of James Rage. James Rage is one tough cookie, but Jason Evans, he's here to win his first match. He doesn't care who he has to go through. He'll go through everyone. He'll go through a Rage. He'll go through drama. He'll go through either Chandler or Brad to become king of JOW. But right now, getting planted on the top of his head. One, two, no. James Rage has pinned not only the world champion Archetype, but the king, the current king at JOW. Not the king for long, however. At the end of the night, we will have a new king. It may be James Rage, but Jason Evans kicking out. James Rage pinned clean the current king, King Ninja. And who better to become the king than James Rage? After getting those two wins, after everything he's done since arriving at JW, still yet to become champion, as he's mentioned in that promo. He's ready to get something for his troubles. He's ready to finally have some sort of gold around his waist, or rather on top of his head. James Rage. If I were to choose someone to win this whole thing, it would be James Rage. Not to count out Jason Evans, who's showing a great fight here. Look at these double sentons. But James Rage has been fighting far too hard and far too long to have nothing to show for it. With the frog splash now from Evans, 1, 2, 3, no! James Rage kicking out. We're not worthy, says the crowd, says the Royal Kingdom crowd. That's exactly what you want to hear if you're Jason Evans, if you're hoping to become king. But look at Rage planting Evans on his crown. 1, 2, 3. And James Rage will face Duke Drama in the final semi-round matchup. And that gets James Rage one step closer to becoming king. But great opportunity, great fight from Jason Evans. James Rage, the one coming up tall here tonight. Boy, a great debut from Jason Evans. Great things to come for his future here in JOW. That is the bracket. Ignore the Hemi. It's supposed to say Israel. But this is what we're looking at for the semifinals. Now we're kicking things off right up next with Azrael taking on her opponent, who was Helen Valiant. She kicked off the show with a win. Can she now exit the semifinals, moving on to the final round, moving on to her final challenge of the night, where she has an opportunity to become queen of JOW? But first, we can't look past Helen Valiant, who showed one hell in of a fight against Bella Lockjaw in that opening, not opening contest, but in that opening round. She went one-on-one with the Exhibition Women's Champion. She came out on top. But in the same point, Kelsey Azrael went one-on-one with the Women's JOW Champion, and she came out on top. Both these two successfully defeated the champions of their brand. And right here, this JOW's main roster colliding with the Exhibition roster. Who will come out on top going to the finals? I was super duper duper impressed with the opening round from Helen Valiant. getting a massive return singles win for herself. As I mentioned, currently 0-0. Was before tonight 0-0 this year in the singles division. And then she lost her returning tag team match at GameShifter. But that win against Lockjaw was all she needed to reinstate the flame in her soul. Now, Helen Valiant is looking to defeat Kelsey Azrael one-on-one in the semi-final round. Bell has rung, here we go. Straight the gates, Helen Valiant tossing Kelsey Azrael back. Kelsey with a kick to the midsection. Another one, a chop, a back fist. And now, hoisting her up into the Falcon Arrow. Just like we've seen from Warzone earlier on in the night. Kelsey going to the top rope now. Looking for a very, very quick victory against Helen Valiant, but caught with the cross body attempt. And now pin 1-2. No, not quite enough. Of course, both these women now have been through grueling contests against two champions, the two top women in JOW. They may have came out on top in the first round, but they are nowhere near 100%. Now Helen on the top with an elbow drop. Now twisting on the arm. Can she defeat Kelsey Azrael? Right here, 1-2-3, no, almost had one. Kelsey just doesn't have very much left. She's gonna do whatever she can, whatever it needs, just hang on into this one. But after going 1-on-1 with Natasha, she does not have much left in the tank. That running knee strike plants into the face of Helen Valiant. Now taking out the leg, taking out the knee, and powerbomb, a powerhouse pops. Twisting the arm once again is Helen Valiant. Another kick to the midsection. With these chops, a big roundhouse. And now, making her way to the top of the rope, turning around. Look at that, a thing of beauty from Valiant. 1-2-3, no! Kelsey Azrael kicks out. But she's not got much left. It just needs one big move, and Helen Valiant can get herself a victory. But same goes for Kelsey. Helen can't have much left after going 1-on-1 with Bella Lockjaw in the opening contest. Or the opening round. I keep saying contest, I don't know why. Count of one on the outside as Kelsey Azrael takes down Helen Valiant. Onto the floor. And now look at this. Look at this as she just pounds in the face of Valiant. And now tries to get the knee. Valiant was able to get out of the way. Takes down Azrael. Picks her back up. And tosses her right back into the ring. and a big boot as Helen was getting back into the ring. Got connected and met with by the big boot, but just tripping. Kelsey stealing the victory. One tooth, no. But she knows how close she is as she climbs to the top rope. Let's do it again. This time a moonsault. What fight we're seeing from Helen Valiant in the Royal Kingdom Tournament 2022. But look at this. Kelsey trying to get her way back in this. With those punches, and now grounding Helen Valiant as she's perched on the top rope. Jumps right over. Helen Valiant connects with the big boot. But no, Helen kicks the face of Kelsey with that suplex now, that Northern Lights. As she climbs to the second rope. Missile drop kick on the money, on the mark. 1, 2, no, only a 2 count. 4, 1/2 of Valiant Flame. Helen got the submission hold locked in. Kelsey nowhere to go, and she taps straight away. What a victory, back-to-back victories for Helen Valiant, surprising everybody, surprising the world at what she is capable of. Defeating not only Bella Lockjaw, but now Kelsey Israel. Who will stop Helen Valiant in the Royal Kingdom Tournament on her dream to become queen? Helen makes it into the finals. Will it be Brandi Rhyne, or will it be Kenny Vega? We'll find out later on. But right now we have to find out the first finalist for the Kings Tournament. Will it be Brad? Will it be Chandler? Let's get it going. First, we have the Dragon Son of a Wrath, Brad.
The following contest is a King of the Ring semi-final match. Making his way to the ring from London, England. Weighing in at 255 pounds, the Dragon, Brad.
Wow. That guy's real excited to see Brad here tonight. Who isn't excited to see the former world and tag team champion as he attempts to add the king to his record, attempts to add that crown to the resume. But it's not going to be easy. It hasn't been easy for anybody here tonight. There's been no free passes. There's been no there's been no matches that have not been grueling.
From New York, weighing in at 254 pounds, 1/2 of the tag team champions, Unbreakable Chandler.
And 1/2 of the tag team champions, Chandler Still, after going straight through his own brother, Chance. And now he's looking to become king. He's so close. He's in the semifinals. He just has to defeat the former world champion,
someone he's shared the ring with in the past, someone he's shared the top of the rankings with in the past. But can he get it done? Can he make it to the final round, where he has the best chance of his knight to become king, to become the next person to hold the crown above his head? He's already got that tag team championship. A tag team championship Brad knows so well. One half of the blueprints, of course, with the current king, last year's winner, King Ninja. This is, and look at here, just Chandler Sill soaking it up. He hears the crowd. He's ready to fulfill the destiny, and he's ready to become king of JOW. Bell has rung. Here we go. Brad has already gone through Chandler Sill's tag team partner, Ryan Warzone. But can he do the same to Chandler Sill? Coup de grace straight out of the gates. One, two, no! Brad stays in it. That was a move out of Ryan Warzone's playbook right there. We seen Ryan hit that very move on Brad earlier on in the show. And Chandler says, alright, I've been training a little bit with Ryan Warzone on my time off. Why not use one of his moves? Why not put Brad away with his own move right here? He just hit that powerbomb, which looked very similar to what Brad likes to hit. But he's not looking to put away Brad just yet. He's gonna put him away when he's flush on the canvas right here. One, two, three. No, almost had it. Almost had the match won. But now just looking to climb to the top rope. On the top. Setting up Brad. Crossbody caught. We seen this earlier with Valiant. And now tossed behind and dropped down. One. No, only a one count. I mean, remember that first match? It was Chandler and Chance. That first round match. And Chandler really, it was really one-sided. So Chandler may have the advantage in this one. But not for long. Because look at that. DDT, a thing of beauty. Flipping around, but doesn't go for the pin. He knows that Chandler Sill is going to be fresher than he is. So he's just going to keep on the offense with the TKO now. It's all going Brad's way. He's got to keep it going his way. He's got to completely take out anything in the tank of Chandler Sill, which is what he's doing right here with his submission hold. Let's go with the hold. But look at this. The powerbomb we just seen from Chance. Or Chandler. One, two, three, and put him away. And Brad, just like that, makes it into the finals. Chandler almost had one early on. But Brad, the longer this thing went, he was able to fight his way back in it, fight against the odds, and become
your first finalist for the King's Tournament.
Here is your winner, the Dragon, Brad.
Now he just has to wait who his opponent will be. But we know for sure, we know for certain that Brad will be in the finals. And that is a bracket. We've got Brad, we've got Valiant already qualified for the finals match. But next up, it's Ryder take on Candy Vega to determine who will go one-on-one with Helen Valiant in that finals matchup. Once again, riding her bike down to the ring is Brandi Rhyder. And I would say Brandi Rhyder has to be a favorite to win this entire tournament. That first match, it didn't go very long. It was all Brandi Rhyder, except I think she might have been on the receiving end of like one maneuver from the top of rope. But other than that, it was all Rhyder. She just punched and kicked and chopped her way right through the debuting jester in that match, through Jesse. And now, Brandi Rhyder looks to keep that momentum going, looks to keep it going as she goes one-on-one against the veteran. The legend, the exhibition general manager, Candy Vega.
From Columbia, South Carolina, Big Evil, CKV.
Let's go. As said by the dude in the audience. Come on, let's go. We are ready. Let's do this thing. Because Candy Vega comes straight off of the Jester match herself. Both these women defeating two jesters to get themselves into this matchup. Candice Vega. She wants to, she wanted to defeat the best in, that we have to offer here in JW. Brandi Rhyder is certainly on that list. She's tired of being overlooked. And if she can get a big win against her general manager, her boss, the person who pays her paychecks, well, that would certainly stop her from getting overlooked any further. The bell is rung. Here we go. And look, just like Brandi Rhyder did earlier on, going heavy in with the strikes, looking to end this one early, is Candy Vega. As Candice just kicking in the legs now. It's wear and tear on Brandi Rhyder until she can no longer fight. Now Candy on the top with the moon salt. One, two, three, no. And repeated shots into the forehead, into the face.
And repeated shots right on back from Brandy. It's time to go straight to straight with Brandy Rider. Brandy Rider is just that good. Just that damn good. That she can go straight to straight with pretty much anybody on her roster. And she is right. She has been overlooked. She was the one and only person not to be featured from the exhibition roster on Game Shifters. But she has been overlooked for far too long. She is ready. She's finally ready to get that crown on her head and being overlooked. Get herself the recognition she deserves. But Candy's here. She's here to step in the ring with the best. The best that we have to offer. Big knee strike. One, two, three. And look at that. Just like that. With that knee strike. Brandy Rider gets herself the finals. And once again, not the longest match. Maybe took a bit more damage compared to the first one. But, I mean, Candy Vega was a part of the longest match of the night so far with Jada. So she was definitely worn out, and that one knee strike just took. The one knee strike turned out the lights for Candy. Brandy Rider is going to ride her way into the finals, where she will go one on one with Helen Valiant. We have three of the four finalists confirmed. It's time for the final finalist. It's time for Duke Drama to go one on one with James Rage. One of the two will make it into the finals. The other will be stuck right here in the semis. It's time. It's drama time. It's time for Duke Drama to qualify to the finals.
The following contest is a King of the Ring semi-final match, making his way to the ring from Houston, Texas, weighing in at 257 pounds, Duke.
Duke Drama, the best, arguably the best competitor down in exhibition, the first ever exhibition men's champion. And tonight, I mean, on the women's side, it's all exhibition competitors. We're going to have a queen from the exhibition roster this year. On this roster, on the men and the Kings tournament, Duke Drama is the last chance exhibition has to be getting the king on their side. Otherwise, James Rage and Brad are on the main roster. If they are to win, it would be going there.
And his opponent from Warsaw, Poland, weighing in at 275 pounds, the Dragon Guy, James Rage.
Duke Drama, successful in his main roster debut, taking on Big Time Trelly. He's now got the Big Time inside of him. He's bringing that Big Time right into this matchup as he goes one-on-one with James Rage, who just defeated the debut and Jason Evan. But this is your final semifinals match. Who do you guys got being the... Oh, just chopped the ref there. He said, three for drama, one for you, referee. James Rage ain't taking any chances. He's taking out everything that moves in this one. And now he's going to the top, turning around. Oh, look at the agility of James Rage. Maybe not what you expect to see from him, but very, very welcomed. Dudrama still in this one, though. He did it for The Rock. He did it for himself, primarily. Because he's here to climb from the bottom, make his way to the top. What better way than to beat someone like James Rage? Now stomping them in the chest right there. Elbow drop. Moonsault. As James Rage stares into the crowd. Knee strike, no. Duke Drama blocks. Drama takes the leg, rolls up Rage, and powers him down. Both these guys, some of the strongest pound-for-pound competitors we have. Now one, two, almost had it, but only a two for now. Rage trying to figure out where he wants to take him. Maybe whispering something in the ear of Drama. Drama didn't like what he heard as he fights his way out of it. Drama look for the snake eyes on Rage. And now these mud hole stomps into the chest of James Rage. Now maybe looking for the rock bottom, but didn't quite get it. He's looking for something else right there, but Rage is going low. Drama got back. And now planted on the top of the head. This is how he defeated Evans in the first match, but too close to the ropes this time. Now knee strike. Caught the arm. And lifted it up. GTS in to that German suplex as Duke Drama rolls James Rage into the center of the ring looking for the finish. One, two, no, only a two count. You've got to ask the question, what will it take to put either of these guys away? Both these guys so strong, will never give up as we've seen. Well, with Rage, every single match, look at him. Just look at James Rage. You see those scars. You see the battle wounds on the face, on the back, all over the body of James Rage. He's a fighter. He'll fight right till the end. Do drama. We've seen. Look at the rock bottom. Rock bottom. It's all over. It doesn't matter how much of a fighter you are. It's all over right here. One, two, three. No. James Rage sticks in it. But with Duke Drama, we've seen in that inaugural exhibition men's championship three-way. He fought and fought and fought until he could, until he fought, outfought everyone else. And then with Sam Danger at Game Shifter, he did the exact same thing. Unfortunately, that's coming up short in that 2L3 Falls mashup. It looked like James Rage may have been going for the Dragon Buster. But instead, right there, hitting. One, two, three, got it. Got the cutter and got the victory, giving James Rage the second final spot for the King's Tournament. James Rage pulled out all the stops in this one. It took everything he had to take out Duke Drama. But he's better got something left in the tank if he wants to defeat Barat in our main event.
Here is your winner, the Dragon Guy, James Rage.
James Rage will meet Barat in the finals to determine the new king of J.O.W. King Ninja will give up the title to one of those two men, as you can see here on the bracket. But in the women's queens final, it's about to go down. It's Helen Valiant versus Brandi Rider. One of them walk out queen of J.O.W. What a finals match this is going to be. Both these women.
The following contest is the final in the championship tournament. Making her way to the ring from Green Bay, Wisconsin, Helen!
Both these women have showed so much heart, so much passion, so much fight in this tournament. I mean, especially Helen Valiant, who has gone through not only the X Division Women's Champion Bella Lockjaw, but the woman who has defeated, pinned, clean twice in a row, the JOW Women's Champion Natasha Hemme. She defeated Kelsey, she defeated Bella, and now she looks to defeat Brandi Rider. But what a career-making journey tonight has been for Helen Valiant. Win, lose, or draw here in this finals semi-main event, co-main event. It'll certainly be a career-changing evening for Helen Valiant.
From Hollywood, California, the Legend Killer.
Brandi Rider riding that bike out one last time to the Royal Kingdom Tournament. Will she have what it takes to take out and steamroll through Helen Valiant, just as she has done with not only the debuting Jesse Bandana, but also the GOAT, the veteran, the icon, the legend, the general manager of Exhibition, Candy Vega. Brandi Rider has been nearly unstoppable. She has barely taken any damage in these two matches. And that's going to give her the upper hand going against Helen Valiant, who has put on very competitive matches in both these two first rounds. Right now, I think Brandi's just trying to figure out where she wants to put Helen Valiant early on here. But right now, Helen tossing around Rider as Rider tries to land some of those strikes we've seen earlier that got that win against Jesse.
Helen's been watching Brandy. She knows what to look out for. And she knows exactly what she needs to do. The question is, will she be able to do it? Will Brandy Rider scale even better? Well, that's going to determine who Queen of JRW is by the end of the night. But I want to thank everybody who is still here, who is stuck around for this Royal Kingdom Tournament 2022. Been a great night. This is what we've been waiting for the entire night. We'll find the Queen of JRW. We'll find the King of JRW up next. Don't go anywhere. Things are about to get good. Get some moonsault there. 1, 2, 3. No, Brandy Rider kicking out. Kick to the head. Brandy gets a shot in on the head of Valiant. Picking up, hoisting up Helen Valiant, and now a knee strike. Once again, getting her to her feet. But no, Valiant fighting her way out of that. Kick to the midsection. And once again, the O'Reilly combination. One, two, three. No, I thought that was it. I thought she was a new queen of JOW. But Brandy Rider still has the fight and the tank and the oxygen and the fight left in her. From behind, forearm smash from Valiant. Kick to the midsection, takes out the oxygen of Helen. Brandy picking up Valiant. Both these women have to be exhausted. This is the third match in one night. There's no way they're at 100%. 1, 2, no. Kicking out once again. And now a big knee strike. Taking down Helen Valiant. And now bow. Knee strike, and now look at this. Just the submission hold locked in. Will Helen Valiant tap her right here? Will Brandy Rider become queen off the pinfall? Valiant may be all in out. 1, 2, 3. No! That was a millisecond. That was 2.9. But Helen Valiant somehow still in this one. Somehow. But not for long. Lights are out. Lights have to be out after that shot. 1, 2, 3. No, again. Again, last millisecond. Kicking out is Helen Valiant. And from the top, elbow drop averted. Shot of Valiant's own. Valiant climbing to the top turnbuckle. Turning around, moonsault connects. 1, 2, no, kicking out is Brandy Rider. There can't be anything left in the tank. It's gotta be all over. This submission has to end it right here. And she does. Helen Valiant is your new queen of JOW. And look back at this fight. And keep in mind, this is after two fights earlier on in the night. This is our third match in the past 2 hours. And Indian leaves that submission hold. That gave Helen Valiant the biggest victory of her career. And the only thing left to say is all hail Queen Valiant. And that is your queen. It's time to find the king. Will be Brad, will be Rage. We're about to find out the new king of J-O-W. Brad is in the house. Brad is here to become your new king. And what would it mean if you were to become king? Because we know the history between the current king, King Ninja, and Brad, former tag team partners turned to rivals. I mean, we look back at their friendship slash rivalry semi recently. But we may not have to ask that question any longer because James Rage is here in the finals. Can he get the job done? Can he get his first real accolade, thing to put on his resume? He has never won a championship yet in JW, which is very, very surprising given how good he is. Bell has rung. Here we go. Shirley Gates, look at this, going for the pin early on. 1, 2, no, Brad kicking out. But this can end any time. Both these guys, through 2 matches so far tonight. And this is their third. But yeah, Brad and King Ninja have a lot of history. What would it be like for Ninja to be giving up his own crown that he's been holding onto on top of his head for a year, 12 months, to Brad, who he has a very up and down relationship with, going from being blueprints, former tag team champions, to members of Oak Inc., till eventually breaking up as a team, going to Born for Glory, number one, facing off against each other, and then just recently reinstating that rivalry as a part when Brad was trying to go after the world championship once again. But then you got James Rage, who also knows King Ninja so well, defeated King Ninja clean one-on-one not so long ago. Either way, both these guys have shared the ring with King Ninja in the past. Both these guys have gotten wins over Ninja as well. Both of them are so deserving of becoming your brand new king, but only one can do it. Everybody in this tournament has earned respect one way or another. Queens and Kings tournament. Whether they made it to the finals, whether they made it to the semifinals, it doesn't matter, because they all put up a great fight here tonight. 1, 2, three. No, that was almost it. That was almost over. This one, like I said, can end any time. It can go for Brad, it can go for Rage. It can really go any way. Who do you guys got becoming king of JOW? Now, it's hard to predict, but earlier in the night I said James Rage is my pick, so I'll stick by it. He deserves this one. He's deserved this one for months, ever since he arrived at the Interpromotional show. He's been putting on great matches, getting huge victories, but he's never been able to get the big one. But Brad might have won it right here. 1-2. No! James Rage kicks out. James Rage still in the fight. But caught that. I think Brad may have been going for that power bomb, which would have been the finish. And look, the knees into the spine. That's one of Rage's best moves. And now looking for a submission hold, but too close to the ropes. And now Rage, look at that, the agility that James Rage has been pulling out tonight. Not something that I'm used to seeing from Rage. Traditionally more of a brawler, but he's looking for the finish right here with the Dude Buster, but maybe changing his mind. Instead of picking the leg and kicked away. Roundhouse kick and a knee strike into the Poison Rana. And now setting up James Rage, who's been through two hellacious matches so far tonight, into the power bomb, the Dragon Sin of Wrath. 1, 2, 3. And your brand new second ever King of JOW is Brad. What a tournament. What a night. Both sides put so much on the line. This tournament could have went any way. But it went with Queen Valiant. And now Brad is the king of JOW. Bow down and all hail King Brad. And thank you all for watching the Royal Kingdom Tournament 2022 right here on YouTube. This is the ending bracket. Thank you all for watching. We will see you next week, as well as for exhibition throughout the week. I don't know the exact dates quite yet. But we will see you for the fallout of the Royal Kingdom Tournament, plus much, much more next week. Next Thursday right here on YouTube for sure.
Hello, I am TMGOW's official artificial intelligence commentator. But you can call me Mary. I am so, so glad you stuck around to speak with me.
I have something to
show you.
Over the past few weeks, we have seen somebody in a jacket and face mask assault AJ Adams and Frankie all over the arena. We have no real leads on who this may be. Until now, as the smartest official artificial intelligence known to mankind, I believe I have a valid list of who this hooded harmer may be. Suspect number 1. Liam Robinson. Liam Robinson has been known his entire career for these types of cowardly attacks. Now that the new and probably not improved blacklist is up and running, who else but Liam to cause this havoc against allies of former Oak Incorporated leader Jackson Oak? I calculate a 87.3% chance of Liam Robinson being behind these JOW attacks. Suspect number 2. Jackson Daniels. Jackson Daniels also has numerous reasons of motive to go after the allies of a man who has been known to stack challengers for his championships up for him. Plus this week his god-awful promo kept him off the show. This happens the one week the attacker also stays home? Coincidence? I think not. Jackson Daniels has also been known to talk behind his friends' backs, just ask Mark Ramirez. I calculate a 69.69% chance of Jackson Daniels being behind these attacks. Suspect number 3. Brian Azrael. Brian Azrael has been on an edge in recent weeks. In interviews and backstage interaction, he's been on record stating the following. It's time to make myself opportunities with force. And, Jackson Oak, you fucking mark. I calculate a 59.2% chance of Brian Azrael being behind these attacks. Suspect number 4. Alex Gemini. Alex Gemini, the less fat member of the Gemini bloodline, has raised suspicion of making it clear he doesn't want suspicion around his name. I calculate a 32.8% chance of Alex Gemini being behind these attacks. Suspect number 5. AJ Adams. AJ Adams has been thinking a lot recently after repeated losses. What if he got to the point where he decided, screw it, I am going to attack myself? Now you may be wondering how that would be physically possible for a man to be seen attacking himself live in front of a live audience, but you must understand. As JOW's official artificial commentator, I have the intelligence you can only dream of. I calculate a 103% chance of AJ Adams being behind touching himself. Of course, these are nothing more than theories. If you know any information on who's behind these attacks,
make sure to tell this to JOW management.